Hi family, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dora. On this channel we talk about how to take care of your 4C natural hair in the most healthy way that you can do. So in today's video I'm going to show you how I detangle my hair, but most importantly I'm really going to also tell you why I no longer put anything like a comb in my hair. And the reason why I don't put comb is I have actually discovered that 4C hair does not need combs, because some of these combs are very destructive. Every time you put a comb through your hair, you're actually ripping it. So in this video, I'm showing you the process of how I actually detangle my hair using my fingers without necessarily having to use a comb. So before you do this process, you need your water. Water is our best moisturizer. And if you can have aloe vera, but use water. So watch the technique. This is what I normally do. Before you do anything on your hair, begin by spraying your hair with some water or some aloe vera. And of course, for those of you who are heavy with like cream, my hair loves cream. So this is my homemade shea butter. If you want to know how I make this, there's a link up. Make sure you watch that video. This oil is extremely moisturizing for 4C hair, and it also acts as a very good detangler, especially for hair that has been in plaits. As you can see, these are the ends. You can see there's some resistance there, but then with oil, the hair begins to loosen up. And I don't think I'll be ever putting a comb in my hair, because there is no comb that will, smoothen out your hair. And I think this whole thing about combing hair is because we have been preconditioned to believe that, you can only grow your, you cannot stay without combing your hair. But I also want to show you that you can actually do without combing your hair. You only need to use your fingers to detangle your hair. The best part about using your fingers to detangle your hair is that you can feel the single strand knots. You can feel where there's resistance with your fingers, but the comb will not be able to do that. Usually when you're running a comb through your hair, you end up ripping your hair. And this is the reason why you are struggling to grow your hair. But also for most of you, you complain that your hair is not thick. You want fuller hair on your head. How do you get full hair on your head when you're combing your hair and ripping out your healthy strands? So in this video, I'm simply showing you how I do it. And for me, this process is very rewarding. This process has actually made me realize that using anything like a comb is not necessary, or a brush. So this method even helps you to take out the single strand knots. So always begin from the bottom and then work your way coming upwards, just like the way I am doing it. And you can see that as the single strand knots or the shed hairs are beginning to come out. It is very normal for us to lose hair. Shedding hair is a normal process. This is hair that has been, plaited for 1 week. So this is my routine. I do this once every week, and it is really working out for me. So this is what I do before I shampoo my hair. And again, I don't use shampoo nowadays. I have kind of now stopped that. So you can see this is just the amount of hair that has come out. And this is shed hair. It's not even hair that has broken off my head. So use your water. Make sure your water helps you to moisturize your hair. Also, it takes away the the tension or the dryness, because when your hair when your hair is dry, it can easily break off, and the oil helps you with the sleep. So if you're not heavy on butters, I would advise you to use oil like grapeseed oil. It also does a great job. Some people prefer to use olive oil. It also does a great job. The thing about oils and butters is discovering what really works for you. And once you discover what works for you, just go for it and just follow it and make sure you have a routine that is consistent. So you can see I'm very heavy on the use of butter, but I'm doing this because I'm also preparing my hair for wash day. Never wash your hair when your hair is not detangled, because this is a time when your hair is at its weakest, and once you start pouring water, you get knots. So when you detangle your hair before you wash it, it makes the wash day very interesting. Now you can see at the ends of my hair, I'm giving it more butter because this is where most people lose their hair. And if you're looking at length retention, to retain the length of your hair, make sure the tips of your hair are fully moisturized, because this is what you need to always do in the process of if you want to grow long, healthy, natural hair. So basically for this, you need to create time for it. Never work on your hair when you're in a hurry. Never start this process when you have to do other things. One more tip about growing healthy, natural hair is that for you to grow healthy, natural hair, you have to be patient. Patience is an important virtue in growing healthy, natural hair. So one of the things that I always tell women who ask me, how do you grow your healthy, natural hair, is I always tell them it's all about patience. So guys, you can see my hair is actually long. I no longer use anything like a blow dryer. I don't put anything like heat on my hair, but that does not mean that my hair is not long. What I'm more interested in at the end of the day is having healthy hair. Health versus length for me is what is the most important. And then after, I just plait my hair in a loose twist. I loosely twist it so that when I'm washing it, it is very, very easy for me to wash through my hair and make sure that everything is washed out. And of course, then you twirl the end of your hair, just like the way I'm doing it. And this way, in case you're not yet ready to wash your hair, your hair can stay in that place. And also it helps you to remove out the shed hairs. So this is what I have lost, guys. And you can see this is minimum. It is acceptable than if I had run a comb through my whole hair. So this is it. You can see that I'm now done with it. And this is what I normally do to detangle my hair. So it depends. If I'm not ready to wash my hair, or for some reason, I can actually keep this for one or two more days before I do this. So in the next step, I'm going to show you how I unravel these loose twists. It depends on how now I'm going to unravel, and then I'll make bigger plates for me to be able to wash my hair. So guys, this is it. You can see that my hair is fully detangled. I can easily separate it. And for me, this is what I believe all 4C girls should be doing. When you use your fingers as much as you can, you're going to definitely have fuller hair on your head. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. If you have enjoyed watching this video, give your girl a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe. Don't forget to hit on that notification bell so that every time I post a new video, you are the first to know. And if you're visiting my channel for the first time, welcome, welcome.